Other audience questions?
Good morning. Well, we've heard that it takes a village to raise a child, and we've also heard that it takes a community to prepare a pre-service teacher. And this is directed at Star Herman. What role does the community have in smaller learning communities?
We can't do it without them. You know, we can't do this. I mean, I'm in a brand new office. The Office of Innovation and Redesign is the name of this office. We can't do this without every part of the district office being a part of this. It doesn't belong to us. It belongs to Learning and Support Services. It belongs to the physical building initiatives that go on. We even have a new school that's going to open, and it's going to open as a smaller learning community school where there's physical adaptations made so that it's easy to put them in separate places in the building to do the smaller learning communities. And we've got to have more parent participation for this to be successful. Also, in the social emotional part of what we need to do, we've got to have help from nonprofits to help us with that type of teaching and learning. Every teacher that comes into education is not equipped to deal with some of the issues that come up with people in high school, youngsters in high school. So we have STARS counselors, we have people in all different parts of this community that we're bringing to the table to help us do that. As a matter of fact, we're looking at that on Friday with a large group of people about how to bring together some initiatives to put those supports in place.
And I think I saw a question in the back.
This sort of follows with the last question. How are we preparing teachers to collaborate with people in the community, whether it's from nonprofits or from businesses, as opposed to just having a program come in? How are they actually going to interact individually to develop it as a teaching experience?
Okay, I'll answer that one. Well, as we move toward our career and thematic academies, that's going to be a really important part of it, because all of those academies are going to have an academic part and a technical part. And we will need, you know, help from the outside to make the realistic experiences they need, whether it be job shadowing or whether it be internships or mentorships or however it's going to play out. We've got to have those people at the table. So as we get ready to plan this, we are really not looking, it's going to be owned by the district, but we're looking at bringing a lot of people together in the community from nonprofits and for-profits to help us decide how this needs to happen for the city of Nashville. I mean, the city's got to know that this is important and that we've got to bring a lot of players to the table to make it happen. And then teachers have got to understand how to interface with those people. We talk as educators in a different language from the people in the other community. They talk in terms of skill sets. I know as part of our professional development, one of the days is spent on a work site. And this was not just career and technical education teachers. This was science, math, English, social studies teachers. And they heard people from HCA and people from Dell tell them the skills that they felt were important when they hire. Some of those were academic skills, some of those were technical skills. But it helped, they told them what level of education was important for different types of jobs. And it was a very eye-opening experience for the educators. On the other side, it was a very eye-opening experience for the business people to understand the challenges that a teacher faces and to realize that the teachers don't really know what they expect when they have somebody appear at their door and hire them. I mean, if they don't have a resume and they don't know how to fill out an application, they rarely ever say, "Why did your career and technical education teacher not teach you that?" The first thing out of their mouth is, "How did you get through 12 years of English and not know how to do this?" But we have English teachers that don't feel like that's their job. And so that's what this is all about. It's that it's going to be owned by everybody. And in answer to your question earlier, it's not a career and technical education program or an academic program, but that it's a career academy that helps them come out with the skills they need and that they've had input from a lot of different people, even those outside of education.
Gwen, and as an aside to that, one of the sort of exciting things that's going on right now is something called the Teacher Quality Initiative that's been established by the Tennessee Board of Regents under the direction of Vice Chancellor Paula Short. And what she's done is convene a group of practitioners to look at what teachers should know and be able to do when they leave the TBR and THEC and University of Tennessee institutions. So we're actually looking at, of course, my reaction is we need teachers who know how to teach reading and mathematics in pre-K through 8. That's my mantra. So it's grand. I have hope about the preparation of the future preparation of teachers because we're making sweeping recommendations which have been adopted by the Board of Regents. And those regent schools prepare 80% of our teachers. So
thank you for sharing that, Dr. Mm-hmm. Smith.
Can I just add, because Janet may be able to add just some things that we're doing with the small learning community we already have, because we have an advisory board made up of members of the business community that support us, that we meet on a monthly basis, that provide input to us to our curriculum, as well as helping to guide that process for us with our students. Job experiences, job shadowing, funding. But I think that's, some of the key pieces. In fact, those advisory meeting members are meeting with our seniors in the IT Academy on tomorrow, just being sure that their college plans are laid out. These young people have committed now for 4 years to go into IT. What are they actually doing, and what help do they need from the community at this point to get there? So I think there are a couple of critical things that we already see happening. In the training piece, I think a lot of this is you're learning on your feet. It's kind of like going into a teacher preparatory program. Some of it, practice is very different from, what you learn about the philosophy in the classroom. What you learn philosophy is very different than what you see in practice, because it is so dynamic and it is so complex. There's not one day that's the same. That's why, our profession as educators is very different than a doctor's profession, where, they can give you a prescription because they know what course a specific illness is going to run. In teaching, you use one method with a child and it works perfectly with another child. There's no impact. So I think we're learning on our feet in practice with our industry partners, and they're telling us. I mean, we've been meeting now 4 years with them. Every year we learn some things that we will absolutely never do again, and we learn some new ideas of some things that will hopefully help us to make the academy experience better for our young people and have them better prepared for the hope that they have for their future.
Thank you. We have time for about two more questions. And we'll start here, and then the gentleman on the left side there.
Okay, we know that studies are showing we're losing about 40 to 50% of our teachers out of the profession within the first 5 years. And high poverty urban schools particularly are plagued with high teacher turnover rates. What kind of impact does a smaller learning community, collaborative type of design have on retaining your best teachers?
I'd like to answer that one. This is the end of my third year at Stratford, and I didn't know if I was going to survive 3 years, but thank goodness I had a good team helping me and people that I could talk to about issues that I was experiencing. I think we've talked earlier about people coming from different areas, middle class and a white person teaching African Americans. Well, I faced that and a different accent as well, so and a whole different culture. But with help from my fellow teachers, I think that I have grown tremendously and improved my communication skills and understood a lot more about an area of the population that I really enjoy teaching with and working with. So I think, in answer to your question, that by team teaching and by helping each other, we will help to drop that rate.